Hello again, everyone. Welcome to a video on why I love the Sony RX10 Mark III. Now, as you know, I love to travel, and although I own a slew of cameras, they are just not the kind I would like to travel with. Now, at my age, a bag load of lenses just isn't the most ideal photographic experience. That is not to forget the tripod as well as the slider, the drone, the underwater action cam, and perhaps one or two mirrorless backup cameras. I have been using the FZ1000 slightly over a year as a DSLR-like camera that shoots UHD 4K, captures stills of up to 12 frames per second. The FZ1000 had always served my purpose well, at least till when the RX10 Mark III made its debut onto the shelves here in Singapore. It was clearly move aside FZ1000 after that, and hello RX10 Mark III. These couple of months I've enjoyed the RX10 Mark III tremendously to its full capacity. So today I will tell you the reasons why I love it and why I would have loved it even more. Well, first up, I'm going to talk about ergonomics. Now, as a stills camera, the RX10 Mark III is really very, very comfortable, in the hands. It has a very nice, as you can see, very nice, deep grip. The camera is built very solidly and even weighs a hefty 1.1 kilograms fully loaded. Now, if you turn the camera to the underside, as you can see over here, the underside there, you will notice that the tripod mounting hole is also very well positioned. You can even sort of like change batteries without having to remove the tripod plate. So if you are doing tripod work, this is really very useful. At the side of the camera over here, of course, you have the storage area or the storage card housing, but it only takes one storage card. Judging from the real estate of the camera, it seemed they could have included dual storage slots, which would have made me again loved it even more. You will see that there are altogether three manual rings on the lens. So one for focus, one for zoom, and the other one for aperture. Everything is perfect except for the aperture ring, which I find a little edgy to find sometimes when you are holding the camera. I would have loved it even more if they had designed the ring to be a little bit more pronounced. Then it would have been easier to turn. Sometimes it just slips when you go over this particular. So the you can see the serrated parts are actually over here. There is also a switch underneath right over here. A click on and click off switch which you can flick to enable a clickable type aperture control. Thank God for the video recording button. If you take a look here, on the Mark III, it is not awkwardly positioned. If you compare where they have placed the recording buttons on the other Sony cameras, such as the A6 3000 and also the A7 series cameras, the camera has a limited, very limited, as you can see, articulated LCD screen. But naturally, if you ask me, I would have loved it even more if they provided us a flip-out screen instead. So please, Sony, flip it out in the next model. I hope so. Coming from a professional video background, I am happy to see that they left, of course, the right over here, you can see that they left the mic and headphone jacks alone. This allows the RX10 Mark III external audio options, such as fitting a wireless or an external microphone for audio. Sony just has this little habit of removing features, and in this case, they did so by removing the neutral density filters in the Mark III. So what a shame. So let's talk about lens. The whopping 24mm to 600mm at 2.8 and f4. So at 24mm, I can get decent landscapes, great group shots. And at 600mm, I have really nothing to say except that no subject is now beyond my reach, birds, insects, and more birds. However, I felt the aperture dropped a little way too quickly to f4 at 100mm. Unlike the RX10 Mark II, which stayed open at f2.8, right up to 200mm, would have again made me love this camera even more. Because of the long zoom range, Sony has also added a useful focus hole button, which you can activate temporarily to fix focus, fix point focus, so that you can recompose on a subject without focus shifting back and forth. There is also a zoom assist feature. The zoom assist feature is found, of course, within the menu, and you can set it to one of the customizable button. So if you are zoom in, for example, to a particular item, you can press this button. It'll temporarily zoom out, change the magnification, so you can quickly find your subject again, release, and then it goes quickly back into that particular subject. Now, in the stills department, the Mark III shoots up to 14 frames per second, and which is great for action and sports photography. And what is 14 frames per second if you do not have fast and precise autofocus? So the RX10 Mark III adopts fast intelligent autofocus detection of up to 0.09 seconds. Now, I wouldn't say it's the fastest, because I feel that the Panasonic is faster, and also the A6 3000, definitely. But in video, unfortunately, in video autofocusing is just not as fast as I would have expected, compared to, for example, the Canon 80D. Macro shooting with the RX10 Mark III is also fantastic. Now, I can get right up close, if you can see, at 24mm, right? I can get right up close and focus on an object almost touching the lens. So this is just amazing. The this means the camera is simply great for nature orientation. Now, if you don't want to focus close like this, you can step back several feet away and do a tele macro instead into the subject at 600mm with the very same results and magnification. So this is just really an amazing feature. The outstanding feature of the RX10 Mark III is the high frame recording mode. It allows you to capture videos of up to 960 frames or 1000 frames per second, depending on what you have set it to. But I will personally recommend you to set up to 250 frames per second if you want usable results. There is unfortunately still no touchscreen from the first model of the RX10 right up to the Mark III. This is such a shame if you consider that they could have at least added this feature now in the third generation, as just like most of the competitors like the Panasonic and even Canon 80-70D, which has touch autofocus, which proves to be such an important feature, especially in DSLR style movie recording today. Well, all I can say is that I would have loved you even more if you had this feature. Lastly, the Mark III shoots in a UHD 4K. UHD 4K in the XAVC-S codec. There is its full pixel readout, no pixel binning. It is a very robust codec and produces very much lesser noise compression with a higher bit rate. So what is there to dislike in the RX10 Mark III? Or should I say, what is there that I dislike in a Sony camera? As far as the RX10 Mark III is concerned, I would say it perhaps is battery life. You will almost most certainly need quite a couple of extra batteries if you plan to shoot a with this camera the full day. The other complaint, I guess, is of course the very, very well-known Sony menu system.
Well, folks, there you have it. The reasons why I love the RX10 Mark III and the reasons why I would love it even more. If you like the video, remember to subscribe. Again, this is Derek, aka Video Cobra, for Video Lifestyle. Take care, sign off, and happy shooting.